Hey, folks, the heat continues across the valley, kind of like it's supposed to this time of year. We're working our way towards summer, and it feels like it. 90 right now in McAllen, 89 Harlingen, get to Brownsville, 88 degrees there. Still warmer in Rio Grande City at about 96 degrees. If we watch our lows tonight, we barely reached the upper 70s. Our low this morning was 80, and a lot of places won't get below 80 again tonight as the clouds thicken up a little bit. And then tomorrow, a lot like today, mid-90s across much of the area. Southeast winds continuing 10 to 20. A lot of clouds early, probably some afternoon sunshine, but another very warm day with about a 5% chance of an isolated shower. So most areas will stay dry. 93 is the normal. We'll be above that. 96, 95, 94. The records shouldn't be threatened anytime soon. We don't see a massive heat wave coming in. Just a normal, maybe a little above for this time of year. Clouds, we've seen some, and we will see some tonight. We'll thicken up overnight. You wake up in the morning to cloudy skies and enough moisture that you'll think it ought to rain, but it probably won't. As we go through the daytime, then we just see partly sunny afternoon skies. Overnight, we see clouds come back in. Models are hinting at a brief shower in a few spots on Friday. A front stalls to the north of us, a little disturbance kind of moves up that front. Could be close enough to trigger an isolated shower for us on Friday. So we're bumping that chance up to about 20%. And then Saturday, I think it's dry again, but maybe that isolated shower. So we're mainly dry, 20% mainly dry. And we put that mainly dry, you're looking at 5 to 10%. That's about it. So most areas, if not all, stay dry. Look at the rest of Texas tonight. Notice the contrast in temperatures. 90 in Austin, 73 in Dallas. You've probably heard that's because there are storms now just east of Dallas. Take a closer look. All of northeast Texas under a tornado watch, a couple places under a tornado warning. In particular tonight, we're getting reports of damage out of Canton, which was just hit a couple of years ago with a devastating tornado, and there's reports of more injuries as the tornado went through there tonight. Still two more warnings on the map. Again, Dallas is way over here. They're out of the tornado watch, but east of that, they're still under the watch, and again, in some places, a warning tonight. Again, a bigger picture, this shows damage in Kemp, near the city of Kemp at the Cedar Creek Country Club. Damage reported there, that's that same storm. Right, going right through the Canton area tonight. So folks up there really on alert as this front triggers strong storms up in North Texas. The front makes its way down to South Central Texas tonight into tomorrow, probably triggering rain, but notice most of that's green. There's not a lot of yellow and red on there, so severe stuff, isolated, not widespread like today. Front stalls to the north of us. Disturbance comes along, triggers rain on the front. Maybe a couple of showers here Friday. Saturday could be a leftover shower, maybe sea breeze activate, something like that. Then after that, I think we're dry again with maybe by the middle of next week, a chance of rain coming back in. We'll look more at that coming up in the next half hour. In the bay, winds out of the southeast, 10 to 15 knots, a moderate chop on the bay. UV index remains extreme. No advisories right now. There's a moderate risk of rip currents, 1, 2, 3. Tides, seas get up there, 3 to 8 feet. Your first 4 to 5 AccuWeather with the forecast for tonight. Clouds thicken up. It's warm and humid. 79 for a low. Some places not getting below 80. Then tomorrow we climb back up in the mid-90s with some morning clouds, some afternoon sunshine. Southeast winds at about 10 to 20. Here's a look at the next few days. 96, 95, 94 with nighttime lows going down a little bit as well. Isolated thunderstorm, best chances Friday, probably dry over the weekend for the most part. And then Tuesday, Wednesday, slight chance of a shower back in the forecast. Once again, some tropical moisture gets into the mix. Again, we'll look more at that in the next half hour. That's your updated First 1-5 forecast.